From the Large Hadron Collider located in Switzerland to the first nuclear device detonated in space, here are 8 experiments that could have destroyed the world. Number 8. The Kola Superdeep Borehole. When astronauts landed on the moon in 1969, humans had conquered space. Although space was not so well understood, people knew little about the Earth's core. A year later, Soviet scientists began excavating the deepest hole in the world. It was on the Kola Peninsula of Russia and took 24 years of excavating to reach a depth of 40,000 feet, which is 12.2 kilometers. They couldn't dig further due to extreme temperatures of about 350 degrees Fahrenheit or 180 degrees Celsius. The hole terrified many people. Some feared that it would allow demons to escape from the pits of hell. Some claimed the hole would cause seismic disasters like volcanic eruptions. Rumors also spread that the diggers heard cries of damned souls emanating from the bottom. In the end, we learned more about the Earth's geology than ever before. They filled the hole with concrete and abandoned the site in 2008. Number 7. Project Cirrus. Project Cirrus is an experiment right from the military's Black Vault. On October 13, 1947, scientists flew an airplane over a hurricane leading west from east and far from the land. Their crew dropped 180 pounds of frozen carbon dioxide, known as dry ice, over it. Their mission was to cool the storm enough to precipitate the water and form normal clouds. After sowing the hurricane with dry ice, it changed color and direction by 120 degrees. It then slammed into the town of Savannah, Georgia, killing one person and causing $3.2 million in damages. The U.S. government conducted similar experiments from 1962 to 1983, this time under the name Project Storm Fury and with silver iodide replacing dry ice. They later concluded that hurricanes lack enough supercooled water for effective seeding. Number 6. Starfish Prime. Nuclear bomb tests have occurred in most environments, like underwater to depths of 600 meters, above ground and underground to depths of more than 2,400 meters. Some bombs have been detonated from balloons, on top of towers, in horizontal tunnels, and in space. The United States Air Force made history by detonating Starfish Prime in space on July 9, 1962. When it exploded 248 miles over the Pacific Ocean, the 2,200-pound bomb yielded 1.44 megatons of force. The night sky lit up in a dancing red aura for 7 minutes, but not without consequences, of course. The resultant electromagnetic pulse destroyed electrical systems 800 miles away. But the biggest threat was the destruction of the Earth's geomagnetic field. It deflects solar winds whose charged particles can strip away our ozone layer. Without an ozone layer, no life on Earth would be possible. Before we go on, can you guess the number of nuclear bombs ever detonated? There have been 2,000 nuclear explosions. It's amazing that we're still surviving. Number 5. Bioweapons experiments. Governments around the world experiment with chemical and bioweapons in secret. That includes the United States, North Korea, Russia, China, among others. The most dreaded bioweapons include anthrax, botulism, smallpox, tularemia, Ebola virus, and Marburg. Here are some details about anthrax. Anthrax is caused by the spores of the Bacillus anthracis bacteria. It's one of the most produced biological weapon in the lab, but also found in nature. The spores can enter the human body through the skin, digestive system, and the lungs. Weaponizing anthrax involves mixing the spores with food, water, sprays, and powders. In 1979, a deadly anthrax outbreak in Russia claimed 94 lives. The Soviets were experimenting with bioweapons despite the Biological Weapons Convention of 1972. Top nations had outlawed stockpiling, development, and the production of toxic and biological weapons. The USSR also attempted to weaponize the plague, Marburg virus, and the Ebola virus. In 2001, the USA reported its first anthrax attack. 4 letters laced with anthrax spores were sent via the U.S. postal system. The recipients include Senators Tom Daschle and Patrick Leahy, NBC News anchor Tom Brokaw, and the New York Post. About 43 people tested positive for the disease, and 5 died. Despite treaties and conventions, experiments that aim at weaponizing chemicals and pathogens continue. Let's hope that an accident, as often depicted in apocalyptic movies, will not end humanity. Number 4, artificial intelligence. Whether you like it or not, artificial intelligence is the future. Now, picture computers that think, talk, learn, communicate, replicate, and repair themselves. Are you still wondering how AIs destroy the world? There are some theories put forward. Oxford philosopher Nick Bostrom warns us of the creation of a machine capable of improving itself in this century. A time will come when it learns to make money from online transactions, then use the proceeds to buy parts from the real world. Since it's super intelligent, it will figure out how to ship and use the parts to build simple nanosystems. These will become complex systems, enhancing its power to influence the world. If humans try to stop it from improving, it will create weapons and wage war. If we are unable to stop the advancement of robots, they will wipe us off the face of the planet and dominate. K. Eric Drexler, a pioneer of molecular nanotechnology, suggests a different end of the world scenario. He came up with the gray goo theory, where self-replicating nanobots destroy the Earth. Picture one self-replicating molecular nanobot floating in a bottle of chemicals and minerals. It can use the resources to make copies of itself. One molecular nanobot makes another in 1/1000th of a second. Two more bots make others in the same interval. By the end of 10 hours, you would have over 68 billion nanobots. They would outweigh the Earth in 2 days and consume all biomass. First, look at the advancement in robotics before dismissing this as science fiction. Number 3, search for extraterrestrial intelligence, also known as SETI. SETI's goal is to answer man's troubling question, is there life on other planets, stars, or galaxies? For this purpose, the SETI Institute has set up the Allen Telescope Array in California. The facility has 42 telescopes involved in astronomical observations. They also search for extraterrestrial intelligence. SETI also monitors for radio transmissions from other planets. Beyond observations, the Institute sends signals into space. What is in the signals, you may ask? Write about everything that would give hostile aliens instructions on how to invade and conquer us. Some of the messages include the human DNA, a detailed map, and instructions on how to locate Earth, pictures of humans, and even the total population of the Earth. Do people even believe that aliens exist? A poll conducted by YouGov found out that 65% of American men and 46% of women believe in aliens. Furthermore, there have been snapshots of flying saucers. People have collected debris from crash landings and reported thousands of alien abductions. So, are we alone in the universe? Are there friendly aliens and nasty ones? Will the aliens find us ugly and hideous? Will they take us back to their planet where we will slave in their factories forever? Number 2, TSAR BOMBA. As America tested the first nuclear bomb in the deserts of New Mexico, those involved feared it would ignite the atmosphere. Questioned about this possibility, scientists stated that the odds were 1 in 10 billion. But if there was any bomb that could have burnt the atmosphere, it had to be the TSAR bomb, which was detonated by the Soviet Union on the 30th of October of 1961. It yielded 51 megatons of TNT, making it 1,570 times more powerful than Hiroshima and Nagasaki combined. Its cloud was 64 kilometers or 40 miles, which is 7 times the height of Mount Everest and had a base of 40 kilometers or 25 miles. It flattened brick buildings 55 kilometers, 34 miles away from ground zero, and the shockwave cracked windows 900 kilometers or 560 miles from the blast site. The people that dropped the bomb were given a 50% chance of surviving. Later, the Soviets reported that its full potential was 100 megatons. Why detonate such a monster? Well, the Soviets were flexing their nuclear capabilities, nothing more. Present nuclear treaties limit the testing of such atrocities, but countries continue to expand their nuclear capacities. In fact, Trump's first order as president from a tweet he made was to renovate and modernize America's nuclear arsenal. Number 1, the Large Hadron Collider. This scientific experiment has sparked many conspiracy theories, most due to misgivings about the project, which in turn sparked fear since humans fear the unknown. So what is it? Could it destroy the world? The European Organization for Nuclear Research, or CERN, operates the largest particle physics lab. It sits on the Franco-Swiss border northwest of Geneva. Here, they experiment with subparticles. Typical experiments involve speeding up and colliding the particles in the Large Hadron Collider. By doing this, they aim to unveil all the mysteries of the universe. Their biggest discovery yet was the Higgs boson particle, believed to give all matter mass. Let's look at the LHC. It has a circumference of 27 kilometers, or 17 miles. And it's larger than the 3,834 meters relativistic heavy on ion collider located in Upton, New York. So, it's called large since it's bigger than its cousin. It accelerates ions or protons, which belong to the Hadron group of subatomic particles. It's a collider because the accelerated particles from two beams that travel in opposite directions and collide at four points around the machine. You can also think of the LHC as a succession of superconducting machines connected in a row. Each machine accelerates the beam to a certain speed before injecting into another machine, which accelerates it to higher speeds, and so on. It's housed 100 feet below the surface in tunnels once occupied the Large Electron-Positron Collider, decommissioned in year 2000. This makes it easier to maintain specialized conditions since its magnets have to be cooled down to 456.34 degrees Fahrenheit or negative 271.3 degrees Celsius. There is a tiny possibility that it can create quantum black holes. These are regions in space where gravity is so powerful that even light cannot escape. CERN has acknowledged that LHC experiments could create micro black holes, but it maintains that you will need 10 times the mass of the Sun to create a black hole capable of swallowing the Earth. It also feared that the LHC might open a portal to another dimension, giving passage to the devil and his demons. CERN says that this is not possible. Another fear is that the LHC will release volatile dark energy. A tiny amount could turn everything on Earth into dark matter. The LHC will continue operating for 20 years, so let's cross our fingers. Thanks for watching, and be careful out there. Remember to subscribe, and we'll see you next time on Peachy Planet.